Yeah. From a lonely jail cell, back to the princess hell realm, motherfucker from the dips. Yeah. See, I got to put work back on the street again, bounce back on my feet. What's good, y'all? It's the one and only NY Phenom. If you guys enjoy NFL, NBA content, give this video a like. And if you're new, go and subscribe to the channel while you're at it. Now, let's get to it. Listen. Shout out to Derrick Henry. For real. Shout out to Derrick Henry for getting his contract extension before the franchise tag deadline. Shout out to him. I love to see my running backs get paid, man. For real. Especially a running back like Derrick Henry. Like, real talk, the effect that he had on the Titans, he deserved to get paid. But truth be told, Derrick Henry was done dirty. He was done dirty. I was expecting Derrick Henry to break the bank. Christian McCaffrey got paid $16 million. Okay. Ezekiel Elliott got paid $15.5 million. Why couldn't Derrick Henry get $17-18 million? I'm sorry. If I'm Derrick Henry, I want $17-18 million. At the minimum. Because my thing is this. Unlike Christian McCaffrey, unlike Ezekiel Elliott, Derrick Henry carried his team to the second biggest game that you can play in. That's the conference championship game. This guy, Derrick Henry, carried this Titans team to his AFC championship game. I mean, this guy, Derrick Henry, is a full ammo. Like, for real. Like, Derrick Henry, I know a lot of people call, you know, certain running backs beast mode 2.0. And as a Seahawks fan, it just annoys me because not that many people are Marshawn Lynch. All right, y'all need to start putting respect on Marshawn Lynch. All right, there's only one beast mode. But at the end of the day, this guy, Derrick Henry, if you want to name him beast mode, you can name him beast mode because this guy's an animal, man. 6'3", 247. This guy's 250. 250 at the running back position. All right, that skill, that athletic. And, like, he just got busy, man. He got hot late in the season. And he put this Tennessee Titans team on his back, man. Like, this guy, Derrick Henry, pretty much destroyed the Baltimore Ravens by himself. Okay, you know, he ended the Patriots dynasty by himself because how many passes was Ryan Tannehill throwing? How many passes did he throw versus the Patriots? 15, maybe? I know he wasn't throwing the ball that much versus the Ravens. And Derrick Henry, he benefited the entire offense. He helped the entire offense because my thing, Derrick Henry made the play action game effective. Okay. Teams had to put 8-9 players in the box. And what that did, that opened Ryan Tannehill play action game so he can bomb it down the field to A.J. Brown. Dish it out to Corey Davis. Dish it to his tight end, Juwan Smith. So you got to credit Derrick Henry in the offensive line for that. So at the end of the day, if I'm Derrick Henry, I would have tried to reset the market. I'm really shocked that Derrick Henry only had $12 million. All right, so the contract is $12 million a year on a four-year contract. So at the end of the day, man, it's like, you know, he's getting $50 million overall, but it's like, I mean, man, Derrick Henry, salute to you. At least you got a contract extension. At least you got paid. I mean, that's still a lot of money. Let's not get it twisted. That's still a lot of money. That's still a lot of bread. But at the end of the day, it's like, damn, Derrick Henry. Like, Derrick Henry's a top five bet. You can make a case that he's the number one. Because my thing is, I don't want to give you guys any spoilers because you guys already know I'm finna come out with my running back rankings sometime in the year. But my thing is, like, Derrick Henry was the only running back that carried his team to the by himself. Like I said, he was the vocal point of that offense. It wasn't Ryan Tannehill. Ryan Tannehill did some great things. He worked off the play action. He threw some nice dots down the field. But my thing is, it all revolved around Derrick Henry and that offensive line. So at the end of the day, it's good news for Titans fans. It is, because now you don't have to worry about this being the last year of Derrick Henry being on your squad. Because this offense is built around Derrick Henry. Simple as that. Another thing. Listen. With that being said, Titans also added around $4.5 million cap space. I'm sort of worried about that. As a Seahawks fan, I'm sort of nervous. I can't front, because my thing is, we all know Clowney and the Titans have been in contract talks. I'm pretty much tired of speaking about this Clowney situation. I just want to see something get done. I've been waiting for my Seahawks to re-sign Clowney for the past 3 months, and nothing has happened. I told John Snyder, I told Pete Carroll, I told the entire front office, just pay Clowney's 20 mil because we need a number one edge rusher. Lord knows we need a number one edge rusher. Because we're gonna be leaning on mad rookies like a Darrell Taylor, or you know, second year players like LJ Collier, or some, you know, players that we need breakout seasons from, like Raheem Green. These aren't number one edge rushers. Benson Mayweather, not number one edge rusher. I fuck with Bruce Irvin. He's a rotational player. We need that number one edge presence on the field, so it can open it up for everybody. Benson Mayweather is not opening lanes for Jaren Reed and Puna Ford. Let's cut it out. Okay. So at the end of the day, man, this is bad news, because Clowney has been in contract talks with the Titans since the offseason began. So, I mean, at the end of the day, it's a possibility that Clowney might become a Titan. They added Vic Beasley early in the offseason, which, should be told, I actually like that move. I really do, because my thing was, I didn't think Vic Beasley really fit the Falcons scheme. The Falcons are a 4-3 defensive scheme. That's what Dan Quinn runs. He runs a 4-3 scheme. He runs that same 4-3 cover 3 scheme that he, you know, ran in Seattle. Vic Beasley, in my opinion, is a stand-up edge rusher. I just look at Vic Beasley in that light. That's what the Titans run. They run a 3-4 scheme. So I like that move. You add Clown on the opposite side with the other edge rushers that they have, like in the Harold Landry and Korea. That edge could become deadly. So at the end of the day, we'll see how things play out. But, you know, overall, man, the Titans, they're making moves. And my thing is, the Titans are one of those teams that's hard to judge. It is, because I've been up and down the Titans this all season. I have. Okay. I didn't like the move of them trading Jarrell Casey. I made that known. That, you know, I wasn't a fan of that move. Jarrell Casey was probably the second best defensive player on their team last year, outside Kevin Boyard. So at the end of the day, I still think that's a huge loss. Okay, I think it is. So at the end of the day, you lost Jarrell Casey, Jack Conklin, our starting right tackle. So at the end of the day, it's like, okay, if I was the Titans, I would still keep Delaney Walker. Just keep it a full buck. Even though he has injury issues, you could still use him as a rotational tight end. So at the end of the day, it's like, And, you know, like I said, the Titans are known to be inconsistent. They are. Like, it's hard to trust on Ryan Tannehill to go out and have play like how they did in the second half of the season. Are they going to play Derrick Henry like how they did later in that second half of the season? Are we sure? Like, I don't know. I just have to see the Titans do it back-to-back years. I'm sorry. I live here in Nashville. I know how the Titans get down. Trust me. They're one of the most inconsistent teams that I've ever seen for like the past 15 years. So, at the end of the day, it is what it is. But, shout out to Derrick Henry. Because it would have been messed up. It would have been truly messed up if their best player on their team would have been playing on the franchise tag. For real. So, you know, overall, salute to Derrick Henry, King Henry, and the flesh. You know, I expect him to, you know, probably lead the league in rushing. Okay? I was right about it last year. I was one of the rare few that said that Derrick Henry was going to be one of the most dominant running backs in the NFL. I told y'all he was going to lead the league in rushing. So, you know, overall, salute to King Henry. He's that fucking dude. And I expect him to get busy this year. But that's it. That's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm the Phenomenal One, and I'm out. Deuces. Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', nigga. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', nigga.
Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas.
When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see another day. Feeling energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the west side.